Hello everyone, my name is P. Ranjan Kumar and today I want to discuss about the light. Actually, in the previous classes we are discussing about the light, and in that topic up to the spherical mirror we discussed. And today I have to discuss about the some most important we can say laws by which you can easily form the image in case of spherical mirror for different positions of the object. And we will also know that what will the characteristic of image, characteristic means the size, the you can say orientation and the position of image. So let's begin with the topic. So this is actually the light chapter. We are discussing about the light, and in this we are discussing about the rules of image formation. Rules of image formation, and this is class 5. Okay, so what are the rules? Let's begin with the first rule. We already discussed about the spherical mirror. Let's revise quickly. A spherical mirror is of two types. One was the concave mirror and another was the convex mirror. Concave mirror looks like this one. This is the concave mirror, and the convex mirror is this one. This one is the convex mirror. So if this is concave mirror, if this is convex mirror, and we know that there are various positions related to the convex mirror. Actually, this is new for me and I am adjusting it. So look at here. So for this mirror, this is the pole, this is the focus, this is the center of curvature, and for this mirror, this is also the pole, focus and the center of curvature. But here we are discussing about the rules of obtaining image in a spherical mirror. What are the rules? Rule number one is simple. So because if we already discussed about this, and in this rule it is given that when the light incident parallel to principal axis, then it goes through the focus. Look, I am drawing the diagram here. This is the concave mirror. This is the concave mirror, and this is the pole, this is the focus, and this is the center of curvature. So when light incident parallel to principal axis, what happens? It will go towards the focus. So this is the first rule. First rule is when light rays incident parallel to principal axis, it goes towards the focus. In concave mirror, also in convex mirror. This is the convex mirror. Look here. And in convex mirror, this is the pole, this is the focus, this is center of curvature. When light incident on it, what will happen? It will reflect in such a manner that it is passing through the focus. So this is the rule number one. We can write this rule. Rule is the light rays which incident parallel to principal axis goes through focus after reflection. this is very easy because it is similar as the we can say the definition of focus. In focus, we already discussed about that. When light incident parallel to visualizes, then it will returns back. It will go towards the focus. The second rule is just opposite to it, because in this rule it is said that when light incident parallel to principal axis, then it will go towards the focus. In the second rule, it is given that if light ray incident, look, this is the focus, this is the center, this is the pole. So if light ray incident towards the focus, okay, let me draw it again. Let me draw it again. If light ray incident towards focus, then what will happen? It will go parallel to principal axis. Okay, so this is the second rule, and this is just opposite to the first rule. And in convex mirror also, look, this is a convex mirror. And in convex mirror, if this is the pole, this is the focus, and this is the center of curvature. And when light incident towards the focus, what will happen? When light incident towards the focus, it will become parallel to principal axis after reflection. After reflection, it will be parallel to principal axis. What happened to it? Okay, now good. Actually, I already told you that it is new for me, so it may take some time for adjustment. Okay, then. So when light ray incident towards focus, look, this light ray is coming towards the focus. Then after reflection, it will be parallel to principal axis. It's very simple. So we can write this rule as when light ray incident towards focus. When light ray incident towards focus, then it will be parallel to principal axis after reflection. Very simple rule. The third one is the when light ray incident towards the center of curvature, then it will return back into the same position. Look, this is the concave mirror, and this is the okay. Let me use the technology. This is the principal axis, and this is the pole, this is the focus, and this is the center of curvature. So when light ray incident towards the center of curvature, what happens? It returns back on the same position. It returns back on the same path. So this rule is, this is the third rule. Look, when light ray incident towards this, it will return back to this position. In convex mirror also, look, this is the convex mirror. This is the convex mirror. And in convex mirror, this is the pole, this is the focus, and this is the center of curvature. So when light ray incident towards center of curvature, when light ray incident towards center of curvature, I am drawing light ray incident towards center of curvature, then what will happen? It will reflect such that it is parallel to principal axis. Actually, it is not looking parallel. So let me draw it by a scale. I have a scale. So this is the third one. Okay, I think I did some mistake here. Because when light ray incident parallel to principal axis, when light ray incident towards center of curvature, then it will be turned back on the scale. Okay. When light incident towards center of curvature, then it will return back on the same path. So we can write the rule: when light ray incident towards the center of curvature, then it will returns back on the same path. Okay, the next rule. What is the next rule? Next rule number 4. Rule number 4 says that when light ray incident directly on pole, look, this is the concave mirror, this is the principal axis, this is the focus, this is the center of gravity. This is the pole, this is the principal axis. So when light ray incident towards pole, it will make same angle as the principal axis between the angle of between the incident ray. Means if this is incident ray I, so if this I makes angle theta with the principal axis, then the reflected light ray will also make theta angle with this. Look, I am also explaining here in the convex mirror. This is a convex mirror, and in convex mirror this is the pole, this is the focus, and this is the center of curvature. So when light ray incident directly on pole, it will return back by making same angle with the principal axis as the incident light ray is made. So it means if this angle, means the angle between principal axis and the incident ray is 30 degree, then the angle between principal axis and this light, reflected light ray is also 30 degree. Here this is same for both the mirrors. So we can write if light rays directly incident on the pole, then it will reflect such that the angle between principal axis and the reflected light ray is same as incident light ray and principal axis. Students, it's done here. We studied all the rules which helps us to form the image, and we will also know how the image will form and what are the characteristics of image formed by the concave mirror and convex mirror when object is placed at different positions. So if you want to form the image, then this rules will be very helpful for you. So everyone, I would like to revise this one in short way. Okay, just look at here. Where it gone? Okay, it is here. This is the first rule. First rule is when the light incident parallel to principal axis, it will reflect such that it goes toward the focus. and when light ray incident was focused, it reflects such that it is parallel to phase projection. When light ray incident directly on the incident on the, we can say, center of curvature, then it will reflect such that it returns back on the same position. And when light ray incident on the pole directly, then it will reflect such that it makes equal angle with the principal axis as the angle between incident light ray and the principal axis is. So these are the very, very important tools for the formation of image. So in the next class, I will discuss about the image formation by the concave mirror, by the convex mirror. So everyone, bye bye, have a nice day.